here's the connection. Suppose we take a diagonal matrix, so R plus one diagonal matrix with the dimensions of the symbols on the diagonal. Then that probability matrix here, this probability matrix here is nothing but a conjugate of A. Little factor of one on your dimension. So it's really saying that these tensor chains, in some sense, are really Markov chains. The Mackay correspondence is really a story about probability. I need to say it. And not only that, because we have this relation and because we have such explicit information about the matrix A, we can actually compute it very easily. So remember, A, we know all its eigenvalues and eigenvectors, even in the modular case, the character values. So all these probabilities are just going to be kind of in terms of character values. So these chains are explicitly diagonalizable. And if you have a Markov chain, what you want to know is how rapidly does it converge to the stationary distribution. So you can use character theory, group theory, to figure that out. And here's what a result looks like. So there exist constants. These are universal constants that don't depend on K, such that where you are after J steps, or sorry, after K steps, probability of being at J is that close to the stationary distribution. So you can see that those numbers are getting very small as K is getting large. And this is just for SL2P, where V is the two-dimensional model. And the analytic details to get us to this are surprisingly intricate, even with all that information about the eigenvalues. So we know results like this for SL2P squared, SL3P. There are also results for tensoring with the Steinberg module, which Percy really likes a lot because you move very rapidly, large distance, and you get a bigger bang for your buck when you tensor with Steinberg module. And what I want to talk about next is, remember that the Grinberg-Huang-Reiner result is a result about finite dimensional hop. All I've looked at so far is group algebras. There's a whole big world of finite dimensional hop algebras. And let's look at the Mackay quiver for a finite dimensional quantum group at a good unity. So here, C is an elf group of unity where L is odd and greater than 3. The generators are EFK, relations of probability. about it because we're going to be acting on tensors. And this is the way we need to act on tensors. So work of Chari and Premet from 1994 actually determined all the Indian principles. And that's what we need. We need to know Indian principles, objectives. So the Chi quiver for tensoring simples in this context looks like this. Now, I could have drawn it differently, but I want to use this sort of perspective in the next slide. But I could have drawn it like a line. And then when I got to O minus 1, I have two arrows going back to L minus 2, and two arrows going to 0. And that's because those weights are linked. This is the same quiver for the restricted enveloping algebra USL2, where L is a prime greater than 3. The advantage to working with the quantum group is that it's now we can work with any odd integer. But it's basically the same. L is a prime, no. Any odd integer is a prime. Okay. So I wrote down the adjacency matrix in the case of a fifth root of unity. Again, the probability matrix is just 1/dimension of what I'm tensoring with, a diagonal matrix, and this adjacency matrix. So these are the dimensions of the simples for this quantum group, 1 up to L. So these matrices were supposed to be the same size, but because of the fractions, they got a little distorted. So what I have here. So this is the D, this is the adjacency matrix, and this is D inverse. And you multiply them, and you get this matrix. And this matrix tells me the probability of moving from I to J. So when I'm at the trivial module, 0, corresponding to the co-unit, there's only one place to go, and that's to B. And most of the other ones have just two arrows. So I left these in unreduced case so you can see the pattern. This is a stochastic matrix. So that tells me that one of the eigenvectors is all ones of this matrix on the right. Anybody have a conjecture about what the eigenvector matrix, if the eigenvector looks like on the left? Is the probabilist here? It's the vector of stationary distributions. I'll let you compute that. So we need the eigenvectors, or eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And it turns out in this quantum group of roots of unity case, that circle with a few extra arrows has the same characteristic polynomial as the adjacency matrix for the affine algebra A hat L minus 1. In other words, for the cyclic group of order L. So characteristic polynomial is the same as if I took just a circle and drew some nodes on it, L nodes. Is that it's the same as for the cyclic group. What are the eigenvalues for the cyclic group? Liver? Roots of unity. But remember, what we're tensoring with is two-dimensional. The symbols for the cyclic group are one-dimensional. So there are things like c to the j plus c to the minus j. V has it. V corresponds to the eigenvalue of c plus c inverse. So those are the eigenvalues. The eigenvalues are the same. They're cosine. And notice that two of these cosines are the same. So you have the eigenvalue when j is 0, so that's eigenvalue 2. We expect that, right? Because that's the eigenvalue corresponding to b. And then we have these eigenvalues that correspond in pairs. Corresponding to each eigenvalue not equal to 2, there's a two-dimensional space of generalized eigenvalues. So you have to work with Jordan blocks here, not with eigenvalues. So these examples are exhibiting new behavior, and they're also exhibiting just remarkable cancellation. I told you that the analysis is really intricate. And then there are little miracles along the way that let things work out. In the quantum case, these are not diagonalizable, and you have to work with generalized eigenvectors. And this is going to be the case for any finite dimensional pump algebra. You're more than likely to have to work with generalized eigenvectors. What Percy says is that this seems to be the first examples with these ingredients. So the first examples of Markov chains coming up where you have to do these calculations, and they're pretty strenuous, with generalized eigenvectors. So there's really a whole new story emerging here. We continued. Anyway, so all of the places you go, quote from one of my favorite authors, Arthur Seuss.